Hello there. My name is Derek Bieri from Vice Grip Garage on YouTube and Roadworthy Rescues on Motor Trend. And I have a Model A problem. In fact, I have allegedly purchased another Model A. And also there's rumor that I might be doing another cross-country road trip over on Vice Grip Garage YouTube. Now, last time, Paul was kind enough to help me through my worries and woes. I did make it home with this beautiful machine back here. This time, if I am going to attempt something like that, I want to be, well, more prepared, to say the least. Paul's been kind enough to go ahead and set some things up for me, which you're about to see here, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to the Paulshinn YouTube channel. Paul, take it away.
Thank you for the intro, Derek. By the way, that was a lot of fun and a pleasure to help Derek get home in that two-door sedan. So that kind of actually helped me to help you put together a list of things that you should bring with you on a long-distance Model A road trip. And it kind of changed the way I do my care packages for long-distance Model A road trips too. So I put together a bunch of items, carburetor in my hand, obviously. And I'm going to test them on Gandalf the Green Coupe here. But what we're going to talk about today is what you should bring on a long distance Model A road trip, like a carburetor that's already been run on the car and is adjusted and ready to go, and some of the other things that are really helpful to have on the road with you. What Derek didn't mention though, is we had so much fun doing that road trip in the two-door sedan that he invited me to be on his Roadworthy Rescues Motor Trend TV show. And I flew out to Detroit, Michigan. Derek had bought a 28/29 Sport Coupe that was just basket case, let's be honest. And we just thrashed on that thing for 4.5 days straight. Got that car running and driving, looking good. Then we drove that through downtown Detroit, Michigan. We drove to the Highland Park Ford plant where the Model Ts were made. We got to do some urban archaeology and explore through the abandoned building and the factory. We found Henry Ford's office. We stood in Henry Ford's office. I mean, it was goosebumps. It was one of those once in a lifetime opportunities, not just the opportunity to be on a TV show, but the opportunity to find and stand in Henry Ford's office. Absolutely amazing. Thank you, Derek, for that once in a lifetime opportunity. All right, so let's fast forward. I'm gonna start testing some of the components in this kit, and I'm gonna take you right now to the workbench and fast forward past all this work part so you can find out what you should bring with you on a long distance Model A road trip. Here's what I've done. So I made sure to put everything in there that he might need. And these are the things that I take on a really long road trip myself, with only a rare exception. So number one, you definitely need bright lights, and you definitely on a road trip do not want to hassle with a generator. You want something that's not going to cook the battery. You want bright lights at night because chances are on a road trip, you're going to be driving at night. So 6-volt positive ground alternator. That's a must for long Model A road trips. I know there's some people who say, well, a generator works just fine. Maybe for you it does. In my experience, this is the way to go. So I'm going to put a 6-volt positive ground alternator along with the bracket that goes on the timing gear cover stud. And then that kind of pushes against the alternator so that you can tension the belt with it. So I'm going to include that in the care package. The other thing, he had some carburetor trouble, so I went ahead and rebuilt another Zenith carburetor. This is a Zenith 1 carburetor because I assume he's getting a 29. I'm not exactly sure just yet, so Zenith 1, all rebuilt, tested, ready to go. Always carry a spare carburetor. Even if you just plug a jet or something in your carburetor when you're on a long road trip, sometimes you just can't clear it. You can just pop another carburetor on there, 2 bolts. Hook up the choke, hook up the linkage, fuel line, done. Get back on the road. So always carry spare carburetor. The other thing I suggest for long road trips is to carry a spare pre-timed distributor. So each of my cars has 2 distributors that are already timed to that car. So there's one that's obviously in the car and running. The other one is under the seat or wherever I keep my spare parts. It's pre-timed, and that's why I like the short shaft distributors. I can change one of these on the side of the road in like less than 5 minutes. So I fully rebuilt a distributor for Derek. If you want to know how to rebuild a Ford Model A distributor, I have done that many times already. I'll link in the description below and you can go see how to rebuild a Ford Model A distributor. So spare distributor ready to go. Now, if you were using a short shaft distributor, I always recommend to carry an extra shaft because, I don't know, it never fails. You'll lose it, misplace it, or maybe even strip the end or something. So even though I already have a short shaft in the car, always keep a spare short shaft for the distributor just in case. He had lots of trouble on his first road trip with his water pump. So I rebuilt a water pump and I did this one leakless. So this water pump has the new modern bearing in the front and it has the cartridge in the back. You can't see it because it's all put together, but no packing required. So this water pump is called a leakless pump. Now, unlike some of the leakless pumps, you still have to grease these, not the rear, but the front. The front bearing does take grease, so I'll pre-grease this before it goes out. Make sure this thing's ready to go. Now, another thing that I really recommend, some kind of flashlight, something for working on the car. And these are great, these little hobo freight jobs. But what I really like is this. This is the Odelphi or Odelphi, or I don't know, whatever it is. It's a strip light. And this thing is just unbelievably bright. As soon as I can find the button. This thing is crazy bright. It makes nighttime look like daytime. In fact, in a previous video, I was playing around with this thing and I wanted to see if it was bright enough to use as headlights in a Ford Model A. After seeing how bright this headlamp is, my inner child decided, let's have some fun with it. Of course, since you all know mentally, let's be honest, 12. I decided to see if this would be bright enough to substitute for working headlamps on a Ford Model A. Admittedly, it makes my car look like a Cylon, and it's probably not legal, but in a pinch, it would actually get you home. The thing's really that bright. So these things are absolutely worth their weight in gold. I'll put a link down below if you want to get yourself one of these things. I got a discount code on these. So that's it. I'm going to box all this stuff up. Going to send it out tomorrow morning. Hopefully, Derek makes it home. I can't wait for you to see that video. I'm sure it'll be coming really soon. Anyway, there's a care package. There's what I take on a really long Model A road trip besides extra jugs of water. Sometimes those are just for me, but sometimes they're for the car. Anyway, again, please subscribe right down here, then you won't miss anything. Thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you on the next video. Oh, hey, you're still here. Kind of awkward. You should probably go work on your Model A now. I mean, you know, if you don't work on your Model A, then it won't work either, or something like that. Well, I'll see you. Thanks.